Christ, the Son of the Most High God, we thank God for you now that are listening and you that are watching around the world. Thank God for giving your mind to tune in to this program. We're here to do as we often do, and that's teach God's divine word. Thank God, I often say, for the word of God, for if it wasn't for the word, we would not know what was right or what was wrong. But because of the word draws a line in the sand. You know, I thank God for the many calls that we get from around the country of them who watch the program. You know, we often talk about the fights, the persecution, the slander that we endure for the name of Jesus Christ. And the people hear us talking about that. And I want to personally thank God for one of our brothers. Brother contacted me out of California. I believe it was Thursday or Friday he called me. And he told me, he said, you know, I know you get a lot of fights, a lot of persecution. A lot of people despise you. He said, but I want you to know the other side of it. He said, there's a lot of us out here that appreciate what you're doing. They appreciate. He said, we appreciate the stance you have taken for the gospel. He said, so don't just focus on the fighters. He said, there's some of us out here that are most grateful. He said, we out here too, brother. He told me he's there in California and how different ones have come to him and asked him, have you heard about that preacher down in Alabama? He said, yes, I know it. Someone that have taken a stand on the word of God. Let me tell you something. We're not wavering. Whatever it say, that's that. It's settled in heaven forever. The mega preachers, I know my God, man. They're evolving. They're changing. But we serving the one who said, I change not. And we're not changing. You understand? Whatever this word is against, it's against it. If it was against it, my God, hundreds of years ago, God ain't changed. He the same yesterday. The Bible said today and forever. I don't care the direction the world go. God got some saints over here, my God, that's rooted in ground. They solid. And they built on a solid foundation. Do you understand? Paul said, other foundation can no man lay. Then that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. That's the foundation we on, and we ain't moving. I'm not afraid to preach what's in the Bible. I'm not afraid to preach. Do you understand? I talk like the apostle. I count not my life dear unto myself. Do you understand? All you can do is kill me, and after that, your hands are tied. I'm serving the one that told me not to fear man. He said, but fear that one that's able to destroy. Do you understand? Both body and soul in hell, and that ain't a man. I'm afraid not to preach the word of God. Do you understand? I'm not afraid to preach it. I'm afraid not to preach it. Paul said, woe unto me if I preach not the gospel. I got to preach it. He done my God remove the veil, and on my eyes, I got to show you what he done showed me. When you look at the condition of the world, 1 John, brother 5:19, let's teach the people. 1 John chapter 5, and we're going to start reading at verse 19. Now stay with me in all thy getting, get an understanding. What did it say, son?
And we know that we are of God.
Bible said, and we know that we are of God, and what?
And the whole world lieth in wickedness.
Some of the world lieth in wickedness.
The whole world.
Lieth where?
Lieth in wickedness.
Saints of God, let me tell you something. He ain't necessarily talking about the sinner world out there. Because we know that the world out there, for as the sinner world is concerned, we know it's got to be in sin. But the religious world lieth in wickedness. I want you to hear the word very well. The religious world, the world of religion, them that say they know God. When I look around, I see a mess. I see mess. I see people declaring themselves to be saved who don't know nothing about salvation.
Amen.
But declaring themselves to be saved, why? Some preacher done told them, you all right. You saved. Do you understand? Let me tell you something. This preacher ain't going down that road. If you ain't complied to that word right there, you're not saved. I don't have a get over feel good message for you. Don't have lollipops and butterfingers. All I got is the word of God. Do you understand? My God, I got something, my God, that'll drive filth right out of you. Bible said now you're clean through the word. And that's what you need, something that's going to clean you up. All this corruption out here, these folks don't need no Jolly Ranchers and lollipops. You need something strong. John said a whole world lies in wickedness. Isaiah prophesied. Give me Isaiah, brother, 39. Let me take my time and teach you today. I want to try to help the religious world out here. Isaiah chapter 30, twin, and start at verse 9, brother. Let's take our time. What did he say?
That this is a rebellious people.
Bible said this is what kind of people?
A rebellious people.
Bible said this is a rebellious people. What did it say, son?
Lying children.
What kind of children?
Lying children.
Rebellious people, lying children.
Children that would not hear the law of the Lord.
This is prophecy, and this is the time we are in now. Children that will not hear the law of the Lord. Now, let me tell you something. They go to church. They go to church. My God, many are faithful in going to church, but they won't hear the law of the Lord. Going to church. Let me tell you something. Going to church, my God, is a great thing. But just because you go to church, that don't mean you saved. Salvation must be according to this word right here.
Amen.
Do you understand? My God, man, what did he say, brother?
Which say to the seers.
I want you to get this people now. What they say to the seer. Seer, you're talking about the preacher, the minister, the prophet of God. They say to the seer. What do they say to the seer?
See not.
They tell the seer, don't see what we doing. See not. And you know what? My God, many of the seers are listening to them. Many of the seers are listening to the people. Why? Because they don't want their salary cut. Do you understand? They don't want, my God, their money to diminish. So they listen to the people and preach what the people want to hear. Amen. Let me tell you something. God's preacher got to preach what you need to hear and not what you want to hear. Amen. Do you understand? My God, you got to hear the message from God. God know how to send a message to get all in your business. I ain't got nothing wrote out that I wrote out here last night for you.
Amen.
Do you understand? All I got is the word of God. And as he bring me the scriptures, as he delivered unto me, I'm going to deliver it to you. I ain't got nothing wrote out up here. My God, if I write something out, that's my mindset. Do you understand? My God, I have to do like he says, study to show myself approved unto God. My God, and when I stand up, he got to feed, man, what he wants you to eat. Do you understand? He got to deliver it to me that way I can deliver it to you. If he don't bring it to my mind, it must was not time for it. That may be for the next time. Do you understand? I only can deliver to you what he give to me. Do you understand? What did the book say, brother?
Prophesy not unto us right things.
Telling the seer, don't prophesy unto us right things. We don't want to hear what's right. That man that want to marry another man, he don't want to hear nothing against that. He don't want to hear, my God, man, Leviticus 18. That it's an abomination. He don't want to hear that. He don't want to hear Paul over there in Rome, my God, man, letting them know, my God, man, that's a reprobate spirit. He don't want to hear about that. Don't prophesy unto us right things. What they say, brother?
Speak unto us smooth things.
We want to go to church, preacher, but don't bother our sin now. Preach them to us smooth things. You see, preacher, I want to come to church and I want to leave feeling good. Let me tell you something. If you're in a house of worship and every time you leave there you feel good, you're in the wrong place. Why? Because the Bible said judgment must begin at the house of God. When you come to God's house, my God, God gonna send a word to show you yourself. Why? Because this is judgment work. Showing you yourself, giving you a time, giving you time and space, my God, man, to repent and make the necessary corrections. You know you ain't living right. You go into a place of worship, and every time you leave, you feel good. You in the wrong place. Do you understand? My God, even these right here, my God, they got the Holy Ghost. They leave here many days living. Can barely make it. Do you understand? My God, but that's what the word's supposed to do. Show you yourself. Do you understand?
Amen.
Paul said you're saved if you keep in memory what's been preached to you. What did he say, son?
Prophesy deceits.
Prophesy deceit. We want to hear some lies, some deceit. What the book say, brother?
Get you out of the way.
Get you out of the way.
Turn aside out of the path.
What he said?
Cause the Holy One of Israel to cease from before us.
Do you hear this? We don't want to hear, my God, man, you talking about the Holy One of Israel. We don't want to hear, my God, what he said. Just prophesy unto us and speak smooth things to us. That's the religious world today. And let me tell y'all something. Many preachers are hearkening and going along with the people. You know why? The Bible called them a howling. What is a howling? A howling is when you hire to do a job. And let me tell you something. My God, you go out here and hire these fellas, my God, to lie to you. Let me tell you, they don't want that salary cut. They're going to tell you some good lies. They're going to even mix a little entertainment in it. Ha! Well, 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 ha! Do you understand? Like they're cutting wood. Do you understand? My God, man, all that stuff is entertainment. That don't hurt you. I ain't got no wood to cut for you. I ain't got no karate. All I got is God's word. And let me tell you something. We're going to speak plain where you can hear all of it. You won't get no hacking over here. Do you understand? What did the book say, brother?
Wherefore thus saith the Holy One of Israel.
Give me Jeremiah 5 and 30, brother. Let me show you, my God, man, here the people. My God, man, and the prophets and how the prophets come along to satisfy the people. Jeremiah 5 and 30 said what?
A wonderful and horrible thing is committed in the land.
A wonderful and a horrible thing is committed in the land?
The prophets prophesy falsely.
Wait a minute. The prophets prophesy how?
Falsely.
You hear all these prophets, all of them ain't got nothing but blessings for you. You hear these false prophets, every one of them just about prophesying blessings for you. They don't look at you, don't never hear them prophesying doom on nobody. No. But the brothers in that Bible, the real prophets, when they spoke, folks got nervous.
Yes, sir. Amen. Fear.
Do you understand? They started to fear. Yes, prophet come in town, my God, they see him and said, comest thou in peace?
Amen.
They want to know, is everything all right? Yes, do you understand? But the prophets of the day, they ain't got nothing but peace and blessings for everybody. God got a blessing with your name on it. Do you understand? Sow some seeds, my God, man, you want to sow a seed where that thing can come up? That's all they got for you. Do you understand? Real prophet come there and run from him. What did he say, son?
The prophets prophesy falsely.
The prophets prophesy falsely.
And the priests bear rule by their means.
Now listen, the prophets are prophesying falsely, and the priests are ruling by the means of the false prophet's prophecy. The priests are listening to them. What you say, brother?
And my people love to have it so.
God said, my people love that foolishness. They love that foolishness. That's the religious world. John said the whole world lieth in wickedness. Do you understand? Saints of God, let me tell you something. Bible teaches us to be not ignorant of Satan's devices. All these different ways out here whereby Satan have for you to be saved, you better try to take that stuff to the Bible and see is it according to the scripture. When one is truly saved, when one has truly been born again, the Bible said they become a new creature. Now look, I want to teach you today. I want to help the religious world. So many folk is saying, I'm saved, I'm born again, but you're still living in sin. Do you understand? You're still doing exactly what your flesh wants to do, but you say you've been changed.
Amen.
What have you been changed from? Do you understand? Jeremiah, brother, 7:9. Listen to me now. Listen to the prophet Jeremiah here. My God, man, he's dealing with this same mentality here. Jeremiah 7 and at verse 9. What did it say, twin?
Will ye steal?
I want you to hear the prophet. The prophet said, will you steal?
Murder.
murder,
and commit adultery.
Listen to this now. You mean you're going to steal, you're going to murder, and you're going to commit adultery. And what?
And swear falsely and burn incense unto Baal.
You're going to swear falsely, burn incense unto Baal.
And walk after other gods.
And go after other gods. Do whatever your flesh want to do. And what he said?
Whom ye know not.
What he said?
And come and stand before me in this house.
Do you hear that? He said, are you going to do all of this? And then you're going to come and stand before me in this house.
Which is called by my name.
Which is called by my name.
And say.
And say what?
We are delivered to do all these abominations.
Do you get this? They saying they delivered. The Lord is saying, you mean you're going to do all this dirt and come and stand before me in this house, which is called by my name, and say you delivered? My question is, what are you delivered from? If you're still doing the same things you used to do, what are you delivered from?
Man.
Give it some thought. Stop listening to these false prophets that's trying to make you feel good. Let me tell you something. In the world, my God, man, we chase women. In the world, you smoke your cigarettes, you drink your beer, you got high, you went to the party. But the Bible said if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. You're not doing the same things that you used to do. If you're still doing the same things, you're not a new creature.
Amen.
And this preacher going to tell you the truth. You need to be born again. Amen. Hear me talking now. 2 Corinthians, brother 5, 17. Let's teach the people. My God, man, I want to stir up your prayer minds, my God, out there and make you think about it. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, brother, and at verse 17, what did he say?
Therefore, if any man be in Christ.
Any man. This got everybody. This got everybody walking the earth. If any man be in Christ.
He is a new creature.
What kind of creature is he?
A new creature.
What you say, twin?
Old things are passed away.
That old girlfriend, that's not your wife. She passed away. Somebody said, no, she's still living. No, she done passed away. She done passed away out of your life. If you're a new creature, let me tell you something. You don't want her no more. Do you understand? If you're a new creature, my God, man, she's a part of those old things. If you're a new creature, my God, man, you ain't down at the casino no more. Amen. Not if you're a new creature.
Amen.
Do you understand? Now, if you still that old creature want to pretend that you're new, you'll try to justify that casino. And say, well, I'm down there eating me some crab claw. You better go to Boiling Pot where they ain't got no slot machines. Do you understand? Hear me talking now. Don't let your good be even spoken of.
Amen.
Hear me talking now. The Bible said if any man be in Christ, what is he?
He is a new creature.
He's a new creature.
Old things are passed away.
Old things. We ain't on a dance floor Friday and Saturday nights no more. That's the old thing. Do you understand? My God, man. But let me tell you something. Folks that's been told they saved and they all right. My God, they'll dance all night Friday night, all night Saturday night, and then be on the choir Sunday morning. Do you understand? Ain't nothing, look here, ain't nothing new about that creature. I say ain't nothing new about it. And you know what? The preachers will allow it. They will allow it. But this young brother right here, my God, man, look here, Jeremiah said, seek for that old path. We stuck in that old path. If you can't live right, don't come up here. I want you, look here, sit out here where you can hear the word of God. But look here, but don't take your unrighteous living to put it up here on display. No, I want you in the God's house where you can hear the word. The Bible said now you're clean through and by the word, but you don't need to be on display now. Do you understand? Look here, I want that feminine fella in the church, but I don't want you up here on the keyboard now. I don't want, my God, man, nobody to get the wrong understanding and make you start thinking that sugar is all right. Said it got to be all right because Ella Murray got him on the keyboard. No, let me tell you something. I want the sugar in the house, my God, man, where we can drive out that sugar. We got something that'll clean up sugar. Do you understand? That's the word of God. Paul says, such were some of you. Such were some of you. What did Paul use? The word of God to drive that gal right out that dude. And to drive that dude right out of that gal. The word will clean you up, but you got to stick around it. Do you understand? Folks need something strong, firm, and tough today. They don't need no preacher playing games with them.
Amen.
When I mean that. And this preacher right here, my God, we're not bowing. We're not bowing. Do you understand? We're not bowing and we're not evolving. Amen. We're stuck right here in God's word. I can't go nowhere. I don't care who leave. I don't care who come. I don't care how long you stay. When you go, when you come back, I'm still stuck right here in the word of God. I'm not budging. Do you understand? We're not budging. We're not moving. Hallelujah to God. Let me tell you something, my God, man. We may not be 1,000 of us here, but we got Jesus. As long as I got Jesus, I'm not worried about nothing. Any gate we approach, he blesses to open of his own accord. I'm not counting heads, my God. As long as I got the head of the church here, everything else is all right. Hear me talking. My God, man, long as we got him here. My God, man, let me tell you something. Long as we got him, we got more than the world will ever possess. Hallelujah to God. What did he say, son?
Old things are passed away.
Old things are passed away.
Behold.
Behold.
All things have become new.
Everything. If you're in Christ, everything is new. You don't think the way you used to think. I don't think about no party no more on Friday night. It ain't no in the back of my mind whether I'm going. I'm a new creature. I don't think like that.
Amen.
I don't think about a six pack no more. I don't think about smoking a cigarette to help calm my nerve. I got something on the inside of me to comfort me. Better than a Salem Light 100 could ever do. You need the Holy Ghost. You don't need to be told you're saved. You need to be saved. Do you understand? When folks get the right spirit, my God, they'll realize, my God, man, that when a preacher come to them trying to pacify them, they'll know he's of the devil. Preacher need to preach the word. A lot of folks will change, my God, man. They'll do better if they knew better. A lot of folks won't do better, my God, because they don't know no better, because the preacher won't preach the word. What did he say, son?
And all things are of God.
All things are of God.
Who have reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ.
You're a new creature. Everything is new now. Your mindset is new. Do you understand? Brother used to hang out, my God, under the oak tree with the fellas. My God, man, shooting dice, playing cards, smoking a little weed. You ain't out there no more. No, sir. You at home now trying to take care of your family. Do you understand? But the ends ain't meeting. You out there trying to work somewhere. And I ain't talking about on the corner selling dope either. Why? Because you're a new creature. Do you understand? My God, if you're new, my God, your mindset gonna change. Look here, let me tell you something. Looking forward to the weekend, my God, I look forward to every weekend. Can't wait till Sunday get here. Do you understand? Can't wait till Sunday get here. Why? Because I'm going in God's word. Do you understand? And his word is a lamp unto my feet. It's a light on my pathway. I can't wait to get to the word.
Amen.
I can't wait, my God, sometime during the week, God just counsel with my mind. My God, this morning, laying in my bed, he counseling with me. I said, look at that. Done read it many times, but this morning, God stepped in and shined a light on something I done read many times. I have to say, like the prophet David, taste and see, the Lord is good, God knows.
Amen.
Do you understand? This is my joy now. I look forward, my God, to the weekend, not to go to a party, but to get to God's house. I was like the prophet when he said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. This is my joy. The joy of the Lord, the Bible said, is our strength. Do you understand? I love the Lord. I used to love the world, but now I love the Lord. It's safe over on this side. It's peace over on this side. I love the Lord. I love him, God knows. Hallelujah to God. What did he say, son?
And all things are of God.
All things of God. If you're a new creature, your life gonna change. You ain't my God, man. If you still got that same old mindset, ain't nothing new about you. I grew up looking at this stuff in church. I grew up. My God, man, went to church. Thank God for my mother. She raised me in church. My God, man, she brought me up to the best of her knowledge. But I can think back how we came up. Wasn't no sin in being a sinner. You do whatever you wanted to do. Just go to church on Sunday. Do you understand? That's what they do. You all right, son? God understand. I wish they was right. But they're not. Before my God, man, or in between service, we had what they call Sunday school, and in between it, we had a break. And after, during the break, many standing out right there, deacons, preaching, everybody, standing right out there just smoking. Just doing their thing. When they get through with that, go in there and leave prayer. Just got out, look him. My God, man, someone smoke out there like they're barbecuing. But then step right back in there, right up in there, my God, man, right on the mourner's bench, bread of heaven, bread of heaven. And we thought it was okay. Now, many were sincere, but they didn't have a preacher to preach to them the word of God. And this is why people, my God, do a lot of this stuff. Let me tell you something. The Bible said, cleanse yourself from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit. You a new creature, my God, man. Ain't no cigarette got no business in your lips. Amen. You a new creature. You have no business, my God, man, dancing at some party Friday and Saturday night. Amen. You a new creature. Let that other man's wife let alone. Amen, brother. You a new creature. Leave that other woman's husband alone. If you're new. Now, if you're not new, you're going to keep doing the same thing.
Amen.
Hear me talking. What did he say, brother?
And all things are of God.
All things is of God.
Who have reconciled us to himself.
What did he say, brother?
By Jesus Christ.
Some said, well, the Lord understands that we're going to live in sin. The Lord do not understand. And the Lord has never justified his people in living in sin. Romans 6:1. Listen to Paul. What did he say, son?
What shall we say then?
What shall we say then?
Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound?
Now, if God understands, if it's okay, why is the Holy Ghost moving Paul to talk like this? He said, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin? Is it okay for us to just continue sin, just to continue to do your thing? New creature, old things are passed away. You can't continue to live that same life. What did he say, son?
God forbid.
God forbid that you continue in sin. What did he say, son?
How shall we that are dead to sin?
You spoke that we that are what?
Dead to sin.
If you're dead to a thing, that thing has ceased in your life. You're not out here practicing sin. Do you understand? The scripture teaches us to flee the very appearance of evil. What did he say, son?
How shall we that are dead to sin?
Dead. Keep saying dead. You dead to a thing. How can we that are dead to sin
live any longer therein?
How you going to live in it? If you dead to it, how you going to live in it? What did he say, son?
Know ye not.
Know ye not.
That so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ.
So many of us as was baptized into Jesus Christ.
Were baptized into his death.
Baptized into what?
His death.
When you went down in water, baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, it symbolizes the burial of Jesus. It symbolizes his death. Because when you repent, my God, what you're doing is saying, I'm willing to die out to my way. When you go down in water in the name of Jesus Christ in baptism, it symbolizes the burial of Jesus. When we bring you up out the water, my God, it symbolizes the resurrection of Jesus. So the Bible says, how can we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Know ye not that so many of us that was baptized into Jesus Christ, we was baptized into his death. In other words, that symbolizes his death when he went down. What did he say, brother?
Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into
death.
We're
buried with Jesus by baptism unto death.
That like as Christ was raised up from the dead.
Just like when Christ was raised up from the dead.
By the glory of the Father.
By the glory of the Father.
Even so, we also
should do what?
Should walk in newness of life.
Right back to newness. Right back to new creature. Do you understand? You should walk in newness of life. Not doing the same things over and over. How in the world, I'm a professor, I'm new, but here the folks, my God, man, that I've been around, they see me doing the same thing. Nothing different in my life. If there's nothing different in your life, it's because you're not new.
Amen.
The people of God, you're supposed to be odd. You don't supposed to blend in. Peter called us a peculiar people. In other words, them folk, they're kind of strange. They ain't involved in all the foolishness, all the lies, and all. They ain't involved in that. Not at all. Hallelujah to God. What did he say, son?
For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death.
If we've been planted together in the likeness of his death,
we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection.
What did he say, son?
Knowing this.
That what?
That our old man is crucified with him.
The old man?
Amen.
The old man. Look here. The old man, that's how you used to be, is crucified with him. Now, don't go back to the grave trying to dig up that old man. What did he say, son?
That the body of sin might be destroyed.
The body of sin may be destroyed. What did he say?
That henceforth we should not serve sin.
Let me tell you something. If we have no control or power over this, Paul wouldn't be talking like this. He said, from henceforth, we shouldn't serve sin. You shouldn't walk after the desires of your flesh.
Amen.
If you're a new creature, Elder Murray is a new creature. God, now fill me with the Holy Ghost. I don't think the way I used to think. Is it possible for me to sin? Yes. But that's a choice I got to make. I want you to hear Elder Murray closely. Satan do not have power, authority, or control over me as a child of God. Do you understand? Not no more, he don't. If I sin, that's a choice I made. I made that choice.
Amen.
But God then gave me the power to resist that devil.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I choose not to resist, that's a choice I made. But as a child of God, I don't have to yield to Satan. When I was on his side, he was my master. And whatever my master said, that I had to do. But I've been adopted now. Do you understand? I'm part of that royal family now. Do you understand? I'm under Christ now. When Satan comes, I got a choice, either to accept or reject him. Hear me talking. A lot of people, even in churches, not rejecting him because they're not being taught to reject him. They've been taught that to yield to sin is okay. God understands. No, if God understood, he wouldn't be talking like that. What did he say, son?
For he that is dead is freed from sin.
He that is dead is freed from what?
Sin.
Freed from sin if you're dead. What did he say, son?
Now, if we be dead with Christ.
If you be dead with Christ.
We believe that we shall also live with him.
In order to live with him, you got to be willing to die with him. What did he say, son?
Knowing that Christ being raised from the dead died no more.
Continue to read, son.
Death have no more dominion over him.
Death don't have no more dominion over him. And because death don't have no more dominion over him, sin don't have no more dominion over us. Death, sin, parallel. Death came as a result of sin. Do you remember the scripture, the day you eat thereof, you shall surely die? Whenever they sin, they die. What brought about death in the earth was sin. Jesus came and got victory, my God, man, over death that gave us victory over sin. You don't have to yield to it now. That's a choice you make. I got power to resist. Do you understand? I got power to resist. Now, if I don't resist, I didn't use the power that he gave me. But I got power to resist. You as a child of God, you got power to resist the Satan now. So I'm going to say, well, the devil made me do it. No, you did it because you wanted to do it. Yeah, he's going to bring it to you. Satan's job is to bring it to you. And I don't care what it is. He's going to bring it to you. He wants you to yield. Read it, son. What did he say?
For in that he died.
He died?
He died unto sin once.
Read it.
But in that he liveth.
What he liveth to?
He liveth unto God.
What is that?
Likewise, reckon ye also yourselves.
To be what?
To be dead indeed unto sin.
He want us to be dead indeed unto sin. That what, brother?
But alive unto God.
Alive unto God?
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Alive unto God through Jesus Christ, which is our Lord. Continue to read something. What is that?
Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body.
Stop a minute. Do you hear how he talked? He said, let not. You got control over that. Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body. Look, saints of God, look in your mortal body. Don't you let it reign. Let me tell you something. Is it going to hurt your flesh? Yes, it's going to hurt your flesh. Because your flesh want to walk after the flesh. But here the Bible is saying, let not sin reign in your mortal body. Don't you let it. What do you say, brother?
That ye should obey it in the lust thereof.
What do you say, son?
Neither yield ye your members as instruments of unrighteousness.
Don't yield yourselves as members of instruments of unrighteousness. What he say?
Unto sin.
What he say?
But yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead.
I want you to get how he keep telling you, you yield unto righteousness. Don't yield to sin. He's letting you know you got power over this. That's what if you didn't have power, he wouldn't be telling you yield and don't yield. You got power over this. Now you got to use what you got. Do you understand? You got to use what you got. A lot of people that think they're saved is not saved. And this is part of the problem. People are hoping, my God, man, and trusting in something that's not reality. I grew up watching the way people so-called get saved and how they so-called get in the church. I grew up watching this stuff. Preacher would get up, and after hacking for about 30 minutes, he'll say, the doors of the church is open. Though I remember as a little kid, when he would say that, I always look at the back. Doors ain't open. He said, the doors of the church is open. Doors of the church is open. So do we have one? Do we have one that want to, you know, be born again, want to come to the Lord, want to get saved? Do we have one? I watched it over and over again. I watched many people that were sincere, but sincerely ignorant. Woke up. They'll have a chair up here. They'll walk up. Grab this wire. Let me show you. For the sake of those who watch, set me a chair right there, bro. Just set me one chair right there. Look at set one more right here, bro. Set one up beside. This is what they used to do, saints. And I watched it. I watched it coming up. Do we have one? Do we have one? Anybody want to be saved? Turn their life over to Christ? Do we have one? And some sincere person would get up. And would come up front. Come on up and watch. You want to be saved? Come on up and sit down. Want to be born again? Secretary would come up. Secretary would come up and sit next to him. She'd sit right here. Where Bria at? Come in, one of my daughters. Come here, Bria. She in the back? Come here. Better yet. Come on. Hurry up, Bria. Hurry up. Hurry up, you'll be my secretary. Hurry up. One of the secretaries would come up. Now, this person that came up sincere, sometimes shedding even a few tears. Want to be saved. Want to be born again. Secretary will come up and sit next to him. She'll have her little pencil and her little pad. There's your pencil and pad. She'll communicate with him before the preacher come down. She'll get his information, get his name, and all that. And then when the preacher come on down, he'll come down and she'll say, Pastor, we have Lewis Watson here. He want to turn his life over to the Lord. He want to be saved and born again. Preacher come down here and shake his hand. Son, I thank God you're tired of running. You need time to be born again now. Be saved. You coming by letter or by Christian experience? By letter? Where your letter at? After the secretary get through taking his information, he tell me how he coming by letter, by Christian experience. Then all the congregation will walk around and shake his hand. Give him what they call the right hand of fellowship. Right then, the preacher tell him in some churches that he's now in the church. Some churches are telling him, you saved now. That is deceit. That's deceit now. Shaking a preacher's hand don't save you. The people coming around shaking your hand don't save you. Secretary taking your personal information do not save you. This is why people, when they get through with this process, they still ain't living right. Because they have not had an experience with God. Nothing has changed in their lives. They're made to hope in something that's not according to the scripture. This ain't Bible. This is tradition. This ain't Bible. This is not how you get in no church. This is not how you born again. This is not how you become a member of God's church. This is not. It's deceit. How do you get in God's church? You don't need my hand. Don't need to shake my hand. You don't even have to know me. But you got to know him. Do you understand? You ain't never have gotten to had to meet me, but look, you have had to meet him now. And when you truly meet him, he gonna get in you and let you know, I'm in you now. And when he get in you, that's when you're born again. Give me, thank both of y'all. Give me 1 Corinthians 20. Let me show you how to get in God's church. Let me show you Bible how to get in God's church. I want Ephesians 1:22. And then give me 1 Corinthians 12. My God, man, and start at verse 12. But first give me Ephesians 1 and at verse 22. What did it say, son?
And have put all things under his feet.
Put all things under his feet. Now, this is talking about putting everything under the feet of his son, Jesus Christ. Now, watch this. What is that?
And gave him to be the head over all things to the church.
Wait a minute. God gave his son, Jesus, to be head over all things concerning the church. And what?
Which is his body.
What is the church?
His body.
What is the church?
His body.
Saints of God, the church is Jesus' body. The church is the body of Christ. The church is Jesus' body. The church is the body of Christ. Give me 1 Corinthians, brother, 12:12. Let me show you how to get in God's church now, how you get in the body of Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and at verse 12, what did it say, son?
For as the body is one.
The body, the church is one.
And have many members.
Hallelujah to God. The body is one. It's one church, but the one church got many members. It's got many members now, but it's only one body, only one church, but many members in that church. What did he say?
And all the members of that one body being many.
And all the members of that one body, that one church being many are what?
Are one body.
What did he say, son?
So also is Christ.
So also is Christ. Remember, my God, man, the church, that's the body of Christ. What did he say?
For by one spirit.
Hold a minute. By one handshake.
One spirit.
By one handshake.
One spirit.
By one spirit.
Are we all baptized into one body?
Do y'all hear that? By one spirit. By one spirit are we all baptized into that body. The way you get in the church, the way you get into the body of Christ is by the Holy Ghost. When God fill you with the Holy Ghost right then, you in the church. Yes, sir. I have folks come here and say, I want to become a member of the church. I ask them if you got the Holy Ghost. They say, yes. I say, you're already a member of the church. Do you understand? Yes, some come and say, I want to be a member of the church. Do you have the Holy Ghost? No, sir. Ask them to give you the Holy Ghost, and then you become a member of the church. Amen. But shaking my hand don't make you a member. Do you understand? You can't join God's church. You got to be born in it. Do you understand? What you're talking about, born in it, my God, man, from the birth of my mother? Not at all. From the birth by the Spirit. When you receive the Holy Ghost, when you've been born again, right then you're in the church. Remember what he said to Nicodemus, except the man be born of water and spirit, he cannot enter. You see, this is the problem. People are hoping in foolishness like that. They thinking they saved. They thinking they in the church. And you ain't got no power to live, right? You got to have power to live this life. And the Bible says you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come up on you. Shaking a preacher's hand don't give you no Holy Ghost. You got to be born again. That's why folks, my God, live right. They talking about they in the church, but they can't live right. They say they're born again, but they can't live right. Why? You've been made to hope in something that's not according to the Bible. When you get it according to the scripture, you can live right. Bible said, my God, after the Holy Ghost has come, you're going to have power. Give me John, brother, 3:5. Start at 3:3. St. John 3:3, and then drop down to verse 5. I got to run fast. The clock done ticked on me. My God, John 3:3 said what?
Jesus answered. And said unto him.
What did he say?
Verily, verily, I say unto
thee. Truly, truly, I say unto you. Except a man shake the preacher hand.
Be born again.
Shake the preacher hand.
Born again.
Except a man be born again.
He cannot see the kingdom of God.
You ain't going to see it, much less go to it. You got to be born again. What did he say, son?
Nicodemus saith unto him.
What did he say to him?
How can a man be born when he is old?
He didn't understand. How can a man be born when he's old?
Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb?
What did he say, son?
And be born.
What did he say?
Jesus answered.
What did Jesus say?
Verily, verily, I say unto thee.
Truly, truly, I say unto you.
Except a man be born of water.
Of what?
Of water.
Of what?
Of water.
That's baptism in the name of Jesus Christ. Except you do this. That's baptism in the name of Jesus Christ. That's your water birth. And what else?
And of the Spirit.
That's receiving the Holy Ghost. What's the condition?
He cannot enter into the kingdom of God.
That ritual right there can't save nobody. Man, you got to be born of the water and of the Spirit. You got to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. And you got to receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Otherwise than that, you're not born again. You're not saved. That's why you can't live right. Preacher telling you you're saved, but you still can't live right. You ain't got no power. Man, all these spirits out here, you talking about, my God, man, I'm saved. You can't live right. The only way you're going to conquer this stuff, you got to have some power on the inside. Otherwise than that, you'll never accomplish this. I don't want you hoping in something that's not according to the Bible. Them rituals, my God, is not scripture. That's not book. Do you understand? He said, except the man be born of water and spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Peter came and preached the same thing on the day of Pentecost. Water and spirit. Acts 2:38, brother. Give me that. I want to show you, my God, the apostles are going to preach the same thing that Jesus said in John 3:3 and 3:5. Acts 2:38 said what?
Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of
you. Repent and be baptized. Hit that water birth, go again. They wanted to know, what must we do? Back up, twin. My God, verse 37. What did he say?
Now when they heard this.
When they heard this.
They were pricked in their hearts.
They was pricked in their hearts.
And said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles.
The people going to ask the apostles a question. What did they say?
Men and brethren, what shall we do?
What do we need to do?
Then Peter said unto them.
They realized we done messed up. We done sinned. What do we need to do? Peter said unto them what?
Repent and be baptized, every one of you.
How many?
Every one of you.
How?
In the name of Jesus Christ.
For what?
For the remission of sin.
And what's going to happen after that?
And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
That's water and spirit. That's water and spirit. That's what they preach, man. Jesus left it on record in John 3:3, 3:5. My God, the apostles preached that down through the scripture. You need water and spirit. That's what they preached. Do you understand? Acts 10:44. My God, man, give me that, brother. My God, you got Peter over here finna preach, my God, to some Gentiles, and something gonna happen to them that's gonna connect back to John 3:3 and 3:5. Acts 10:44 said what?
While
Peter yet spake these words.
The Holy Ghost fell on all them which heard the word.
While Peter was preaching, the Holy Ghost fell down on some Gentiles. What happened?
And they of the circumcision which believed were astonished.
They was astonished. Why?
As many as came with Peter.
Why, brother?
Because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost.
How did they know it?
For they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God.
They heard them speaking with tongues and magnifying God. So they didn't got the Holy Ghost. But hold it, y'all. They ain't been baptized yet. But they didn't got the Holy Ghost even before baptism. Continue reading, brother.
Then answered Peter. Can any man forbid water?
Okay, you got the Holy Ghost, but can any man forbid water?
that these should not be baptized.
That these should not be baptized.
Which have received the Holy Ghost as well as we.
And then what did he say to
them? And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord.
He gave them an option.
He commanded them.
He said, when it warm up.
And he commanded them.
He gave them a commandment. Okay, you got the Holy Ghost first. But Jesus said water and spirit. You got to have both. You got to have water birth, baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, and you got to have the spiritual birth, which is the receiving of the gift of the Holy Ghost. And if you don't have both, your salvation is not complete. Do you understand? You got to have it according to what's written in this Bible. Do not hope, my God, and trust in these man-made rituals, my God, how man come up with ideas whereby you can be saved or whereby you can be put in the church. That stuff don't put you in God's church. You're hoping it's something that's not according to the Bible.
Amen.
That's why you can't live right. When you get it according to the scripture, I got power now to live right. Do you understand? Acts 19, brother, verse 1. While Apollos was at Corinth, my God, man, drop down to verse 3 for the sake of time. Acts 19 and start at verse 3. What happened, son?
And he said unto them.
What did he say to them?
Unto what then were you baptized?
My God, man, start at verse 1. Read it, run fast. What did he say?
And it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth.
What happened?
Paul, having passed through the upper coast, came to Ephesus.
And what did he say?
And finding certain disciples.
He found certain disciples, and what did he say?
He said unto them.
Have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? What did they say?
And they said unto him.
What?
We have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Ghost.
Paul asked, have you received the Holy Ghost since you've been a believer? The people's response was, we ain't heard whether there be any Holy Ghost. What did he say to them then?
And he said unto them.
What did he say?
Unto what then were you baptized?
Do you see the connection? Okay, you ain't got the Holy Ghost yet? How were you baptized? Why did Paul ask that question? Because he know, my God, Jesus said water and spirit. You a believer. You ain't got the Holy Ghost. Then we got a problem. We got to find out where the problem at. Because if you a believer, you're supposed to have the Holy Ghost. Paul asked him, said, how were you baptized? How were you baptized? What did they say, brother?
And they said,
unto
John's baptism.
John wasn't baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. John was baptizing unto repentance. Do you understand? John was baptizing unto repentance before, my God, man, the testator had came and established the testament. Because the Bible says a testament is a force after men are dead. John was baptizing while Jesus was still alive. Do you get it? He was baptizing while Jesus was still alive. My God, after Jesus was put to death, my God, man, Jesus in Luke chapter 24 said that repentance and remission of sin should be preached, Jesus said, in my name, among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. That's after he done rose from the dead, he done established the testament. Now, everything got to be done in his name. Everything now got to be done in his name. So them disciples that were baptized unto John's baptism, now you got to go back to water. Y'all got caught up in the transition there. Do you understand? You got to go back to water now. Get it right. Get it in the name of Jesus Christ. Continue to read, twin. What happened, son?
Then said Paul.
What he said?
John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance.
John truly baptized with the baptism of repentance.
Saying unto the people.
What did he say to them?
That they should believe on him which should come after.
That is who?
After him that is on Christ Jesus.
Here's John telling them to believe on him that should come after him that is on Christ Jesus. And what happened, son?
When they heard this. They were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus.
So they got it right now. When they heard this, they didn't fight it like many are doing today. When Paul straightened them out and let them know, man, John was pointing to this Jesus. When they heard this, they got their baptism straightened out. They went down in water in the name of Jesus Christ. Bible said, what happened after that, son?
And when Paul had laid his hands upon them.
When Paul laid hands on them.
The Holy Ghost came on them.
Hallelujah to God. They got their baptism straightened out. Now God is bearing witness by filling them with the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, and what happened to them, son?
And they spake with tongues and prophesied.
They did what?
Spake with tongues and prophesied.
You that are watching and listening, when you receive the Holy Ghost, you're going to receive it just like they did. Amen. Get this stuff out your head that you can receive it, you know, cause a little chill come over your body. So I got it. Let me tell y'all something. We're coming to a close. Well, let me show you something. Satan is out to deceive you. Y'all hear about murder? Satan is out to deceive you. Satan wants you to think you're saved. That way you won't seek to be saved. That way you won't call on the Lord for the Holy Ghost. Because he wants you to think that you already got it. You know whether or not you got power to live right.
Amen.
You know that. Do you understand? Look, I'd much rather be sure by going back to the altar. Do you understand? Rather than just to say I got it because the one next to me said he got it. Do you understand? That stuff you got going to be tried. When tests and trials come, if you ain't got the real stuff, you ain't going to stand. you understand? You want to be sure that you got it. Do you understand? My God, man, when that trump of God sound, the Bible said the dead in Christ shall rise first. Look here. You ain't coming up out the grave. You still in the dust. Well, I thought he said he was saved. But he ain't coming up. You might have been able to fool mankind. But the Lord, the Bible said, the Lord know them that are his.
Yes,
you can't fool him. When the trump of God sound, my God, and the dead in Christ, my God, man, now caught up to meet the Lord now, you ain't nowhere around. But I thought he was saved. Yeah, you thought he was, but God knew he wasn't. This is something you don't want to gamble with.
Amen.
Because it's going to take power to get you out of that grave.
Amen.
The Bible said, if that spirit, my God, man, that raised Jesus from the dead, if it dwell in you, it shall also quicken your mortal body. But you got to have that same spirit in you that got him up. It's got to be in you to get you up. It's going to take power to get you up. But now, if nothing is in you, there ain't no power to get you up. You want to make sure this is not something you want to play with. Don't let nobody tell you, no man tell you, you saved, you born again. No, sir, you got to know this for yourself.
Amen.
You got to know this. I was told I was saved. Yes, I was. I was told I was saved for years. Man told me I was saved. And they, some were sincere. They didn't know. Do you understand? I came up when I was first introduced to holiness around 18, 19 years old, or better yet, 17, 18 years old. I went in the church. I called Jesus, 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 Jesus. Spirit got a hold to me. I danced all across the front of that church. Brothers came to me after that. Oh, you got it. You got it. Preacher hugged me. You got it. You got it. My feet were still slipping and sliding and everything. But they saying, you got it, you got it. I said, I got it? It ain't got no power. I can't live right, but you're saying, I got it. And someone say, I got it, I got it. I didn't have it. But they told me I had it. Do you understand? This is the danger. I didn't have no Holy Ghost. My God, I can tell you when I received the Holy Ghost. You ain't got to tell me. I can tell you. If you got to tell me that I'm saved, I ain't saved.
Amen.
I received the Holy Ghost at the age of 19 years old in Hartsville, South Carolina. My God, kneeled down in a folding metal chair. My God, standing in the pulpit, it was over in the right wing. My God, man, calling Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. My God, man, and just like it happened in the second chapter of Acts, my God, man, how the Bible said that thing came as a rushing mighty wind. And it filled all the house where they were sitting. I was calling Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. We was in a 2-hour prayer. It was down to the last 5 minutes of that prayer. All in a sudden, my God, man, that spirit got down in me. It got in me. I felt that thing when it got in me. And let me tell you, God, my God, allowed my mouth to come open. I started talking in a language that I did not understand. See, I can share my experience with you now. Do you understand? But all before, folks simply told me, you saved? Ain't had nothing. Don't let nobody tell you saved. You got to know that for yourself. If you ain't never had an experience that's recorded in that Bible and receiving a gift of the Holy Ghost, don't say that. Don't say I'm saved. Your experience got to comply with what's written in that Bible.
Amen.
Satan is out to deceive. I had an experience. And I'm going to share this experience. I've shared it with some. Back at the age of 15, I was one, I always went to church. And I counted myself sincere. But I was sincerely ignorant. I was 15 years old. I was working at the Environmental Center on Gerby Road here in Mobile at 15. I never forget, there at my mother's house, you know, still living at home, in my bedroom, 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, I was asleep. Saints of God, this is the truth in Christ. I lie not. I remember as I was asleep, I woke up, room dark, little bit of light in the room coming from the light through the curtain. I remember looking at my door. And there was an image on my door. You know who the image was? That hippie that's in some of y'all Bibles and that you see in some churches that's supposed to be Jesus. You know the hippie, the fella with the long hair down his shoulder, posing? The hippie was on my door. I said a hippie was on my door in my room at 15. I'm telling y'all the truth. Somebody said, what the hippie doing there? Satan sent the hippie to deceive me. Satan sent the hippie to deceive me. Because I was taught that that was Jesus. So when I looked at my door at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, I saw the image of the hippie on the door. And me being sincere, not knowing, I started praying. I said, Lord, if that's you, please touch me and save me. Saints of God, I speak the truth in Christ. I lie not. I felt the side of my bed when it sunk down, as if someone sat on the side of it. I felt the touch in my side. I'm not making up none of this. I felt the touch in my side. It felt like a soft sponge. I remember the next day, down in the woods at the environmental center where I worked at, they had a lot of animals there, and we go down in the woods. I remember I had on a pair of khaki pants and a white t-shirt with some type of design on it. I remember being down in the woods thanking Jesus for saving me that night. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I was touched by Jesus. Satan sent the hippie. I couldn't live right from that. Hippie came, but hippie ain't had no power. Hippie touched me, but he ain't give me power to live right. For years, I walked around thinking I was saved. What I'm sharing with you all, many people that have similar experiences, it's a trick of the enemy to make you think you got something that, according to that Bible, you ain't got. I walked around for years thinking I was saved. From the age of 15 up until about 18 years old, when I was introduced to the scripture on how to be saved. When I look back at the experience with the hippie, I ain't repented of nothing. I ain't been baptized in no water in the name of Jesus Christ. And I ain't received no Holy Ghost and ain't had no power to live, right? But I've been touched by the hippie. Satan was out to deceive me. God had mercy on me. When the scriptures, my God, man, God opened the scriptures up to me and I saw true salvation according to that Bible, I got busy. And I started calling Lord Jesus. I first repented and got baptized in water, just like that Bible said, in the name of Jesus Christ. And after that, I started calling Lord Jesus, my God. And after a while, let me tell you something, at the age of 19, he came. My God, and the hippie didn't come either. Let me tell you, the real McCoy came. And when he came, got down in me, I started speaking in a language that I did not understand. I could go back and read my salvation now. I can't read the hippie. From that day until this one, I got power now to live right. If I sin, that's a choice I made. It's not because I ain't have power to resist. Don't be deceived. Make sure you got it according to the Bible. Let me tell you something. When tests and trials come up in your life, it's going to take the real Holy Ghost to stand. The stuff that's coming up on this world, it's going to take the real Holy Ghost to stand. It's got to be more than just a dance and a jerk. A lot of folks, my God, they can dance. A lot of folk can sing, but it's more than that. Acts 1, 10, 20, verse 8, I'm coming to a close. My God, let me show you what you got to have here. Acts chapter 1, Bible said in that verse 8, what did it say, son?
But you shall receive power.
That's what you need. You got to have power. Young man can't live this life without power.
No, sir.
Man, all this temptation out here. Not only young man, middle-aged and old man. Young sister can't live this life without power. You got to have something stronger in you than the will of your flesh. You got to have enough power, my God, man, brother. When that woman approach you, you can let her know, I'm saved, I'm married, I'm of God, I'm not about that. You see, it take power to talk like that though. Do you understand? It takes power to talk like that now. You see, if you ain't got no power, you be like, married? Married? How you spell that? Do you understand? Say, what's that? Holy Ghost? What that? But see, when you got the Holy Ghost, you got power, you can speak up. Say, I'm not about that. Say, my wife at the house. Say, my husband at the house. Do you understand? But you got to have real stuff to talk like that. Do you understand? None of this little play stuff. It ain't going to stand. Did y'all hear my mind? I said, this little play stuff out here is weaker than water.
Amen.
Folks are made to hope and stuff, my God. That's not reality. That's not according to the scripture. That's why folks slipping and sliding, dipping and dabbing and everything. You ain't got no power. You got to have power. Now examine yourself. If you ain't got it, it's available.
Amen.
Look here. If you ain't got it, it is available. He gives the Holy Ghost to who? The Bible said Acts 5:32, and take your seat, son. Acts 5:32, we got to get out of here. I'll stop for y'all's sake. But like I said earlier, I love the word of God. I couldn't wait till Sunday to get here. It seemed like it got time to flew away from here. Do you understand? Acts 5:20, start around about verse 32. What did it say?
And we are his witnesses
and
of these things.
And we are his witnesses of what?
Of these things.
And what?
And so is also the Holy Ghost.
So is also what?
Holy Ghost.
The what?
The Holy Ghost.
Who he giving to?
Whom God hath given to them that obey him.
Do you want the Holy Ghost? Then obey it. Obey it. Hear me talking. You want power, saints, to live right. Let me tell you, if you don't have that power in you, you ain't coming up in the first resurrection. Preachers can tell you what they want. As we come to a close, let me say this. The problem with the religious world, on the most part, is preachers. Preachers won't tell folk the truth. They're trying to rub shoulders with everybody and get along with everybody. That's a few folk that, may care a little bit about me, but not a whole lot. Like the brother called him California. He said, don't focus on them. There's a lot of us out here love. Yes, a few of y'all out there scattered. It ain't a whole heap of. Because when you search the scripture, that's the way it was in the Bible. Men of God, let me tell you something. They was few and in between. And most time, when you found one, everybody hated him. Is there a man of God around here? Yeah, that one man. Old Micaiah, the son of Imlah. He said, but I hate him. Why you hate Micaiah? Because he don't speak good concerning me but evil. Why was Micaiah speaking evil concerning him? Because he was evil. You know what the rest of the prophets was doing? Speaking good. A man that's a God, he's going to tell you the truth. He's going to tell you what you need to hear, not what you want to hear. Brother, I thank God for my brother in California. He told me these words. He said, brother, he said, a couple of weeks ago you was preaching. And he told me what I was preaching about on Impact Network, international broadcast. He said, brother, it hit me. He said, it hit me. He said, you start preaching that stuff? He said, I said to myself, Murray need to go on something else now. But he didn't fight the word. He called me and thanked God for the word. Any man being in Christ, you're a new creature. The word may come along and show you yourself. It may condemn you. But if you got the right spirit, you know what you're going to do? You're going to thank God for it. Because the word of God is sent for your help, to help you. You ain't going to fight your help. If you ain't up on something, don't fight it. Ask God to help you come up. And don't try to diminish the word to bring it down to you. Like they do, man. So, well, it don't mean that right there. No, it means just what it said. You just got caught up in the crossfire. Do you understand? You just got caught up in the crossfire. Don't try to diminish it. Just say, okay, it got me. Thank God, Lord, you found me. That's all part of judgment work. The Bible said he chastened them that he loved. And if you, my God, man, is out of the will of God and yet not receiving chastisement from God, the Bible said, whereof all are partakers, and you're not being chastised, the Bible said, that's because you are a bastard and not a son. What's a bastard? A fatherless child. A child that don't have a father that's concerned about him. So, as look, if I'm a child of God, when I'm out of the will of God, God going to chastise you. Leave the church hurt and wounded. Lord have mercy. They ain't never going back there. After a while, God counsel with them. What time service start next Sunday? I'm going. I got to. Do you understand? What, look, I want to go get beat down a little bit more. Why? Because you realize judgment began where? House of God. And if I let this word beat me now, my God, man, then I can reign later. But if I receive my God, man, if I refuse to be corrected now, then look, then I'm going to be judged later when the world is condemned. But let me be condemned now. I got time now to work out my salvation with fear and with trembling. My God, man, but when the Lord come, I ain't got time to work out nothing. The Bible said, he that is filthy, let him be filthy still. You ain't got time to change nothing then. Right now, my God, man, you got time to repent and get it right. But you need a word to show you yourself, to show you where you need to repent. You don't need nothing to make you think you okay and you are not okay. Until next time, peace be unto you.